All right. This is.
Okay, this is supposed to be getting to know Bola session. I think that's what this is all about. We're actually in the studio, just relaxed and let me see, music. Where did music start from? The funny thing is, I really never knew I could sing. I just knew I loved music so much. Wherever there was instruments, wherever there was a band playing, I found myself there. And just hang around backstage. Well, not backstage, but behind the instruments. And someday, I just wanted to, sing. I remember in my high school, I think it was my second year in my high school, probably first year. Anyway, sometime around there, I was singing and, you know, the people were like, wow, you can sing. I really never knew what it meant to know how to sing. I knew I just loved, I wanted to sing. And that's how my, you know, my music career started. My early years of music, I've been influenced by a lot of different people. Bob Marley definitely played a big role in my life. Believe it or not, New Edition definitely played. Cool it down, gotta cool it down. Michael Jackson, everybody, Michael Jackson influenced everybody. One other very big influence in my life as far as music is Lionel Richie. He was definitely big in my life. Not until couple of years down the road in my music, you know, career, early teenager into music, a producer friend of mine called Jide Omidera said to me, you know, then I was playing hip hop and, you know, R&B, and I love it. I still love it. I sing some of the songs, but he said to me, you know, it's a slap on the face if you don't know how to sing. If you don't know how to sing your own. Your own country, you know, style of music from your country. And of course that's basically reggae music, African music, and that just stirred up something in me. And you know, I took that as a wow, you know, I have to go learn how to do this. And ever since then I just fell in love with, you know, reggae music, African music. In my early stage, I really wanted to get a contract. So if I go to a recording label and I ask, you know, I play my demo, they say, you know, you have to change your style a little bit. You have to, you know, sing this. In those days when I do demos, I had all kinds of styles of music in it. But, you know, today I sing music because I love, you know, I sing what I love to sing. Regardless, my target, my goal is not to sell 1 million copies. That would be great if, you know, I can sell that. I just sing music because I love it. And I will keep doing this until I die. So the direction or the purpose for this music is just me. I'm in the studio just jamming, having fun with my friends. And that's what it's really about, you know. So it's not, you know, about trying to have the next hit record. No, I just do it because I love it, and hopefully to translate to my fans really getting the spirit of it. So. Well, actually, really, I must say, my wife has been amazingly supportive. I have failed so many times in my life, but the worst failures have been after I got married. But amazingly, my wife has been like a pillar. She stood by me in the worst of the worst when nobody had any reason to believe in me. Even when she didn't have reason to believe in me, she believed in me. And my kids, too. Hey. They just know daddy's having fun. So, but my wife has been a tremendous, you know, help. And I don't want to sound like everybody sounding well. Thanks to my wife. Thanks. No, I mean, without her, I'm in deep, deep, deep trouble. So shout out to my wife and everything in the album. This album for me, you know, it's not about me. There are amazing talents that have gone, time and talent that's gone into this album. You know, we have all kinds of people. I didn't write all the songs. In fact, some of my best songs on the album were written by, you know, friends, you know, just normal people, everyday people. And when you check the sleeves, you see their names on it. People like, I was inspired by I Love You So Much, I Love You So Much. It was a high school kid, yeah, Daniel Abubakar, his name is, you know, a high school kid, we went to this high school concert and this kid sang the song and it blew my mind. That same night we went into the studio and did our own version, you know. So thanks to Daniel and everybody that has, you know, worked on the album, did an amazing job. So, you know, watch out, amazing talents from my hometown back in Nigeria, West Africa. Well, the message I really want to send out to my fans, and regardless of what you do in life, regardless of what, where you are or where you go, life really is not worth life, you know, without a meaning. And I'm talking about Jesus Christ being the meaning, you know, in your life, the center of your life. Before I got born again, I used to think, you know, man, when I get born again, I have to become like some freak who, you know, all those Christians you see hanging around or walking around and they look like some. And I thought, you know, it was not cool, you know, to be Christian. But I honestly would say that's the best thing that can ever happen to you. And I'll be more than glad to talk to you. My email, of course, would be on my, you know, sleeve. And I think my phone number. Anyway, my email will be the safest one to save. And I'll be more than glad to chat with you about him. Any day, any time. He is all I stand for. So my message to my fans, if you're listening to this, is, you know, consider giving Jesus a chance in your life. I don't know where you're at right now. You might have just bought the CD because I look good on the sleeve. That was a joke. But you might have just bought it because, hey, reggae music, Christian reggae music. But honestly, I would really highly recommend, you know, giving Jesus a chance in your life. Accept him as your Lord and Savior and see your life change. The song I would like to come after this particular section of interview or whatever you want to call it, Getting to Know Bola, would be What Will I Do, which is the title track for this album. And reason why is I remember I was so depressed one morning. I woke up very depressed. And I, you know, those moments where you really don't feel like yourself. You woke up from the wrong side of the bed. And I really didn't know what to do, and I walked into the studio on the keyboard, and heck, I don't even play keyboard very well, but those chords, I just was playing it and I was hearing this song. And regardless of where you're at today, that song, I pray that this song would lift you up and make you know or help you understand that God is all for you. And all you have to do, like David said, was my soul arise and praise the Lord. So if you wake up this morning not feeling like praising Jah, just tell your soul to rise and praise the Lord. And I hope God will change your life. God bless you.